Hey there everybody and welcome back! For those of you that are interested in learning how to create your own expanding text box similar to this right here, so that instead of typing all the way across the screen, it will expand vertically, stay tuned, I'm covering the basics of how to do that in AppGyver while we're making free codeless applications. Now before we get started, don't forget to like and subscribe and check out the channel for new content. Now, if you aren't familiar with AppGyver, the quick 10-second explanation is it's a codeless application development platform helping you to build mobile and web apps without coding, and they do have a free community edition. I have multiple tutorials on my website at codelessfix.com, as well as templates for sale, custom apps for sale, and different application tutorials on my YouTube channel as well. Now let's jump straight into how to do this text box because it's very quick and easy. So jumping into AppGyver, we have two options and we will be using my chat app as an example. You can look in the description for a link on how to build this. So you'll see we have a couple of options. Now the first input field, which we have right here, is just your standard input field, which you can drag over. So you'll see that is just this one right here. Now you'll see, I just want to show the difference between the multi-line input just to kind of show how it works. So we're just going to turn that on for this message field. We'll go to the chat and you'll see the messaging right here is where we have multi-line input. So you'll see that this is already enabled by default, so it'll expand and shrink once you have multi-line input selected. Now, you do have another option if you want to create a different type of multi-line input for your application. So the second option is going to be to create an actual chat box yourself. Now, if you want it to look differently. So you have two choices. Either you can edit this component here by clicking this edit option, and then you can change the various styles, layout, and properties, or you can basically make your own. To do that, like we have here, we'll walk through that very, very quickly. So we have a container that we can drop in, and we'll actually delete this and make this together from scratch. So you will start off with your container, and you can go up here and click edit and basically change whatever properties that you need to. Now, in this case, you're going to want to look under the Advanced tab, make sure that you set opacity if you need to give it kind of like a little bit of a fade or anything like that. But what we're going to be looking for is borders. So you have the option for none that's selected by default. We can choose solid. And if you just want 1 to 2 pixel border, whatever the case is, you can set that here. That will give this outer border. Next up, we're going to go grab a primitive component, which is the input, and we will drop that in here. And then you'll see that we have multi-line input as an option in here as well. So it's about halfway down and we'll select true. And then what we're going to do is go ahead and click save. Now, this video is being prompted by this forum here. You'll see that this was something that was being attempted quite some time ago. I think the multi-line input is a feature that basically shows that this isn't really needed as a workaround anymore, but did want to at least show it. Now, I am screen mirroring my phone, so this will work specifically on mobile devices. You would need to do your own testing for a web app, but we're going to type in text here by just holding, and you'll see the multi-line input is now working and expanding as expected, and clicking on backspace does the same. So your two options here are to either use the original text component or the input field and do the formatting there, or if you want something a bit more custom, you can do what we just did and edit this input field here. And basically what you can do is try to edit the container and set it up to really match whatever formatting or style you need. I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions, drop them in the comment box below, and I'll see you all in the next video.